So the day after, how was
I think he's good. Said he felt good. No setbacks, so he'll practice today normally.
What are you planning on working on today in practice?
Same as always, defense, big chunk of it. And then offensively, just trying to smooth some things out.
How much of the last couple days between Kobe practicing on Tuesday and Saturday have made things more realistic in terms of you starting to think, oh, I can actually game plan having this guy?
Well, I want to be a little careful because we're going to have a few games before he comes back. We don't want to. We want to try to win as many as we can, if not all of them. But he's kind of an easy player to fit in. He's going to do what he does. We know where he likes to get the ball, and we'll go from there. The biggest thing is just getting him back in game type situation, game ready, and that's just going to take a while.
What talks have you had with him about how many minutes?
We haven't got there yet.
When you say game ready, is it more just like wind and conditioning, or there's
wind, conditioning, timing? I mean, there's so many things. He hasn't played since April, and it just takes you a little bit. So I think he surprised everybody by how he did already. But again, it's a little bit different from practice than the game time. It's going to be a little bit of a process. But when he's ready, he'll know.
But you're ruling him out for Friday.
I am. I think. Yeah. I mean, like I said, I'd be very surprised, but I don't want to say something that I even words, but, yeah, I don't think so, yeah.
Have you started to think about what adjustments you'll have to make when he does come back?
Yeah, we think about it all the time. The main thing is getting guys back in different roles that they're accustomed to and talking to them, making sure they're comfortable with how we rotate everything. You know, playing with Kobe should facilitate everything, make it easier, especially offensively. Then defensively, he'll have to fit in with our schemes, but yeah, we always think about it.
Do you anticipate him playing more of the two, the three?
There's no difference in what we do between the two and three. The only difference is who he guards. And now we'll see where he is and who he guards. Then you'll say, well, he's playing three. Well, actually, it's the same as a two on offense. It's not anything different.
I meant more just in terms of how it could affect the other guys that you put out there.
Well, then that'll be determined a little bit by the player who's playing really well. We'll nail down a spot whether it's two or three because he can play either one. And we have a lot of guys can play either one. So, again, in our scheme of things, two and three are the same. And there might be certain matchups that we might go a little bit bigger, a little bit smaller, and that might change up things.